Johnny Cash strengthened the bonds between folk and country music so that both sides saw the similarities as well as the differences. He helped to liberalize Nashville so that it could accept the unconventional and the controversial, and he did as much as anyone to make the outlaw rock and roll image possible. The documentary film you're about to see was shot in 1969 and is a rare insight into the life of one of the greatest international recording artists of all time, the man in black himself, the legendary Johnny Cash. This documentary film is a rock classic in its own right and contains highlights of what was an extraordinary year for Johnny Cash, including a tour across his home state of Tennessee and various roadshow gigs accompanied by Carl Perkins and the Carter family. Plus a concert for the inmates of a local state prison, as well as a special performance and blessing at a Red Indian reservation in the state of Arkansas. You can also watch rare film of Johnny Cash and his newlywed wife June Carter at their ranch home at Memphis, and many other touching behind-the-scenes moments with both fans and musicians alike, including an historic recording studio session with Bob Dylan, where he duets with Johnny Cash on a number called Too Many Mornings, A Thousand Miles Behind.
Take one, Johnny Cash, Bob Dylan, A Thousand Miles Behind. Take one.
Just want me to get in closer. Down
the street, dogs are barking, and the day is getting dark. When the night begins to fall, then a dog will lose their bark. Then a silent night will shatter from the sounds inside my mind. And I'm just one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind.
From the back to the room where my love and I have laid. Then I gaze back to the street, the sidewalk, and the sign. And I'm one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind.
Well, the peak of it, really, I think the height. It definitely had a, like a mountain look, you know, from a distance. You could see the going up and the coming down. And I think that there was a period, and I'm associated with a drug, really, with LSD, where we were introduced to and started to take a lot of LSD. And there was definitely, that was around the time under Disraeli Gears, shortly after. And we were touring Scotland. And I think that was the height of it for me. That was the height, that was the peak of the mountain where we were so together and so tight and loved one another so much.
In late 66, I formed a friendship with Chas Chandler. I'd met him earlier when he was part of the Animals, and I'd begun to shoot a couple of bands for him that he was managing. And he came back from New York with this extraordinary man, Jimi Hendrix, and he presented him at a sort of showcase gig at a funny little place called the Bag of Nails. And this extraordinary explosion of colour and drama and music and insanity occurred with Jimmy and Mitch and Noel, really blowing everybody away. And mythology has it that there was every major British guitarist, rock guitarist in the room, and I really can't remember who was there, but they say Pete Townsend and Eric Clapton and Jimmy Page and Jeff Beck were all there, and they were all blown away, and I could quite well believe it, because I think, apart from thus the magic of what Jimmy was doing, there was this extraordinary mystery as to how he was doing it. He seemed to do everything the wrong way round. The guitar was upside down, it was a right-handed guitar being played left-handed. The whole thing seemed like a mystery.
And where you going with that gun of yours? Hey, Joe.
it was easy to see that Jimmy was potentially a genius, probably a genius, but an extraordinary guitar player, and that what he was bringing to the business at that time was something special and something unique.
I met Andrew Oldham at a party. He asked me if I'd like to make a record because he thought I had a face that could sell.
And what did you think?
I thought, this is fine. Perhaps I have. Let's sell it. The world can do what it likes to me. People can do what they like to me. Lovers can do what they like to me. Anybody can do what they like to me. My head's cool.
One does need help. You have to be very honest about it with yourself. You have to admit that you're on the junk heap first. Never trusted anybody. At all. I don't know why it was hard, but I just didn't.